Hi, today I'm going to be showing you what you can make with your Christmas Blockbuster. We're going to be using the Christmas Classics range today, and we're going to make a card using our Deck the Halls topper set. We've gone for the printed cardstock for this project. We're not going to need a card blank, we're going to make a fold back using the cardstock itself, and we're going to pop some toppers on all as well. So let's get started. Okay, so we are going to just pop our toppers out of the way and go straight for our cardstock. Now my favorite size to use for this is a 10 by 7. So we're gonna cut that right away and do that. And then what you will need is an adorable scoreboard so that you can get all of your scores in perfectly. And what we're going to do is we're going to line that up on there and we're going to score all the way down at 5. And normally we would score all the way down at 2.5, which is this point here. However, obviously we have got this beautiful Christmas tree with all of the gifts under it and we don't want to score straight into that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just gently lift that up with my score tool and come back up to where the image starts and ends. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fussy cut that little bit there and we can still have that fold back beautifully. So we're gonna pop that to one side, now our scoreboard. And from where I've stopped scoring to where I've started again, I'm just gonna simply fussy cut this detail as well. Obviously with it being a Christmas tree, there's lots of movement in that branches. So you can just sort of maneuver your craft knife around here. You can get really into these branches if you want to, or you could just get that shape really, really simply. We're going to go around these presents as well. Make sure your craft knife is really nice and sharp for this, and you've got a fairly new blade to use for your fussy cutting. Okay, I'm then going to just press that out and make sure that comes away okay. And then I'm going to gently give that a fold as well. So that's absolutely fine. I'm happy with that. I can obviously go in a little bit further if I want to and maybe neaten up some of these branches and round off some of these baubles. But it is absolutely up to you how much fussy cutting you want to do. And then what we need to do as well is fold our other one so that it becomes a gorgeous 5x7 card blank there as well. We're going to give those score lines a nice good burnish. And make sure our card stays up nice and strong. And then we're going to go to the topper sheet now and pick out some toppers to embellish this card with. So I'm going to save my beautiful big Christmas tree because we have already got that image on there as well. So I think I'm going to go for this smaller one, which has the sentiment included, create magical memories this Christmas. And I think I'm going to put that on the right hand side of my card, just echoing that Christmas tree imagery. Really, really special. I'm also going to go with this square shaped star topper. So I'm going to just pop that out of the sheet now. And put that underneath, and I'm also going to pop, it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, and I think I'm going to put that on my front panel. I'm just going to see how that looks. Perfect. You can play around with the layout and find whatever you're happy with. I'm going to also try these as well and see what we prefer. We've got Deck the Halls and we've got Jingle All the Way. And I think once I am happy with my layout, I can then sort of embellish them. So I am actually going to leave this one off because I'm really, really happy with how it's looking right now. So I'm going to pop all those on with some foam pads. So let's get those on now. So I'm going to start with my largest topper here. and go in with my chunky rectangular foam pads here. It's worth having them all in the different sizes for all your shapes of toppers to go on your cards beautifully. And again, what you can do is you can use your scissors and cut off any pips that are a little bit proud. That's just going to make your cards look really, really polished and professional. And then finally for these ones, I'm going to go in with our circular foam pads on these button toppers. And then I know that they're not going to overhang on any of my rounded edges. Perfect. Again, you can embellish this with gemstones or ribbon or anything else that you want to pop on this, but I'm going to leave this card. It will go perfectly in a 5x7 envelope and fold nice and flat for your recipients. And that is our Deck the Halls card, all finished.